see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night. And I think to myself, what a wonderful
are the stories that I can't explain. I leave my heart open, but it stays right here empty for days. She told me in the morning she don't feel the same about us in her bones.
Something amazed me when I meet people, even strangers. They take one look at me and they think I'm 200 years old. And they say, how are you living so long and having so much energy? And that's an easy one for me to answer. It is because of you wonderful people who love and accept me, even though I have wrinkles and can't hear thunder. I look at you and feel such joy. I embrace you, and lo and behold, your name escapes me, yet you forgive me. Some of you I've known for more than 30 years, and we are still friends. Many of you have bought houses in Lawrenceville and Snellville, and we don't see each other as much as I'd like to. But even after 30 years, would you believe we're still friends? I can never forget our being together, buying the first bathing suits for some of the kids, searching for jobs for people who recently came to America, and for all the new arrivals in the USA. Maybe a favorite memory during this time was with a very sick friend. I remember Nancy and me standing with the family with the bedside of a friend, and the doctor said to her, "We cannot help," this was at Emory, "we cannot help you, and there is no hope for your recovery." Strangely enough, I couldn't believe they left and went to Mexico. And I don't know what happened, but something did. God worked a miracle, and Joan Jane became well. And I hope they're here. If y'all don't be annoyed with me, would you stand, Mauro and Jane? Well, anyway, I think that they are coming. They are like some other people I know there, who's literally arriving. What a wonderful experience. Anyway, and now they have the most wonderful children. And if you're on Facebook, if you're a friend of theirs, every single day, their grandchildren are on. Others of you I've known since you were babies. One of my dearest memories is seeing you leaving your parents as soon as my apartment door was open and running inside to the toy box, throwing open the cover and digging in. Then you were rushing into my bedroom and dragging the train, Cheryl had, dragging the train, Cheryl had given me from under the bed. But now I'm so upset because your son, you must be, didn't be here. And I'm so upset because you've grown up. Because I miss you so much popping into my house. I know I am the most blessed girl in the whole world. I know the parents and grandparents of most of my international friends. Many, a few who are present today, have honored me by bringing your parents to Kingsbridge to visit when they came to the USA, to my home country. Somehow, it makes me feel that I am a part of that whole world. Me, such an ordinary person, and yet I feel a part of this whole world. I can't begin to tell you the wonderful feeling it is to feel a part of our world. The greatest thing that ever happened to me was God calling me to be a missionary in Nigeria. My answer to God was, no, I will never do that. But in desperation, I went to Nigeria with my husband, two daughters, Cheryl and Michelle, and Marilyn, and I spent 20 amazing years. Experiences in Nigeria changed my life completely. I learned that all of us are just people having good and bad times, facing problems and not knowing how to cope with them, feeling lonely and sometimes even depressed, marriages failing, illnesses and death. And I learned something else in Nigeria. I learned that all people have the same needs to have basic human dignity and respect, a decent place to live and sleep, food, family, friends, a place to worship. I have had my part in the song.
Seems to me that when I die, these words will be written on my stone. And I'll be gone, gone tonight. The ground beneath my feet is open wide. The way that I've been holding on too tight, with nothing in between. The story of my life, I take her home. I drive all night to keep her warm in time. It's frozen. The story of my life, I give her hope. I spend her love until she's broke. Stays right here in its cage. I know that in the morning now, see us in the light upon the hill.
When I went to New Orleans, I don't know what chapel, somewhere I sat behind this guy that had the most beautiful ears, and his name was Ralph West.
Frozen.
I am Frances West. I'm sitting in my home in Atlanta, Georgia. On my computer a couple of days ago, I got a lovely message from Seyi Ajamu telling me about the celebration you were going to have of the 160th anniversary of Focalarian Baptist Church. So now I want to start by saying to you, good morning, my friends at Focalarian Baptist Church. I wish I were there with you this morning. I wish I were in a pew sitting on the front row, participating in the glorious 160th anniversary. I am remembering the 150th anniversary because hanging on the wall in my study is a lovely mahogany plaque you sent to me 10 years ago. Also on my wall is a framed letter from the Children's Church I received on the 30th of December, 1970. It was signed, Your Little Children's Church. It was also signed by Aro Arimu and Chief T.I. Johnny. I have a picture of a service with many, many children gathered as Anla Jimo led the worship service and a Bombshell Blind School Band played for the children to sing. These pine people were students at the blind school. And it was a blind school which I, along with Professor Oye Rendy and other leaders in Ogbomoshaw, founded in 1958. I praise your pastor, deacons, and so many of you who have consistently lived the Christian life and brought many people to Christ. Focalarian Baptist Church is the lighthouse for Ogbomoshaw, a light set on a hill to draw people to our Savior. I follow many of your services on Facebook and am inspired by the sermons I hear and find delight in seeing you members rejoicing in our Lord. I thank God and you for letting my husband and me serve for 20 years in your country. In August of last year, I spoke to a group of more than 200 people from 45 different countries. I said, the greatest thing that ever happened to me was God calling me to be a missionary in Nigeria. I learned that all people are alike, and all people have the same needs. We are all related, so we should embrace our differences and love everyone in the whole wide world, regardless of our country of birth, customs, color of skin, culture, race, or religion. We are all one family. I love all of you, my friends, and may God continue to bless the great Focalarian Baptist Church. Amen.
But baby, running after you is like chasing the clouds. The story of my life, I take her home, I drive all night to keep her warm, and time is frozen. The story of my life, I give her all, I spend her love until she's broke inside. The story of my life, the story of my
good morning yesterday. You wake up and time has slipped away, and suddenly it's hard to find the memories you left behind. Remember, do you remember the laughter and the tears, the shadows of misty yesteryears, the good times and the bad you've seen, and all the others in between? Remember, do you remember the times of your life? Will you remember the times of your life? Gather moments while you may, collect the dreams you dream today. Remember, will you remember the times of your life? Of your life? Of your life? Do you remember, baby? Do you remember the times of your life?
Yesterday once more. It was something. songs of love that I would sing to them. And I'd
okay, now everybody can wave or do whatever they want. Everybody can do whatever they want, wave or do whatever.
Sabir, mera picture aa raha hai ki nahi?
Haan, aaya, bahut badhiya. Don't worry. Dekhna hai.
This is the video?
Yeah. It's yesterday once more.
Can be done. What are those 2 days?
What are those 2 days?
Could you repeat it again?
You know.
There are 2 days in the year when nothing can be done.
2 days, what nothing can be done.
New Year's Day is one of them.
No. Do it, Mama.
What?
I don't know. Mama, tomorrow?
Surely you know.
Yesterday
that.
And tomorrow?
Oh, Mom, you must know that.
I think what she's doing.
Is it yesterday and tomorrow?
Yes, the smartest girl.
Yes.
You are really smart. I'm going to end with this one. And I was hoping Donnie was here, and he's not even here. But anyway, I want to tell you what a honeymoon is.
Did you get them?
Really?
Okay, the answer was yes.
A honeymoon is a vacation a man takes beyond starting work. I gotta start all over. A honeymoon is a vacation a man takes before starting work under a new boss. Thank y'all. This has been the most wonderful party I've ever had.
Next year,
I'm going to be a big brother. Thank you, bunch of money.